Hi dears, welcome back. Hope everybody are staying safe and healthy. Yes, before moving to today's session, we'll have a quick recap of the last session. I hope I have ended with a question. Yes or no? Yes. My question is, only green plants do photosynthesis? Only green plant produces carbohydrate? No. We have another organism also which produces algae. Yes, last class we have discussed about the photosynthesis process about plants. Why? Because plants are autotrophs which can produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Let's move on to today's topic. As my question is, only green plants do photosynthesis? The answer is no. Algae is an organism which can also do photosynthesis. Yes. So, algae can do photosynthesis. Why? Because they possess a pigment called as chlorophyll. We studied in the process of photosynthesis, right? So, chlorophyll helps to trap the sunlight, which is the major source of photosynthesis. By this process, this algae or organism, which you can see near the pond, stagnant water, which looks like a slimy green patches all around the stagnant water and ponds. So, these also can go for photosynthesis and produce their own food. Yes, plants only produce carbohydrate. Only the food they prepare is carbohydrate. Carbohydrate is made up of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. See, we have another gas also which is present abundant in our atmospheric air, that is the nitrogen. So carbohydrate is made up of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, but for synthesis of other nutrients like protein, vitamin, minerals and fats, plants need the source of nitrogen. Okay, we all know this nitrogen is abundantly present in our atmospheric air, but how this nitrogen can be utilized by the plant? Plants utilize this nitrogen from the soil with the help of a bacteria called as rhizobium. Okay, what this rhizobium will do, it captures the atmospheric nitrogen which is in a complex form, and it changes into a simple form and give to plants for the production of other nutrients. So at the end, even plants will produce all other nutrients. Okay, why we need nitrogen? Because proteins, fats and other minerals are made up of nitrogen. That's the reason we need nitrogen. Okay, so the plant can able to produce protein, fat, vitamins and minerals with the help of the nitrogen. Are we all clear with this? Next, we have already discussed about two mode of nutrition, that is about autotrophic mode of nutrition and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So autotrophic mode of nutrition we have studied in the last session. Okay, today we are going to enter into the another type of nutrition, that is heterotrophic nutrition. We have already discussed in our first session what are heterotrophs. Heterotrophs of organisms which depend on the other organisms for the nourishment. Hetero is other and trophs is nourishment. So we have here, these are also we can say it as a special type of nutrition. Okay, we have four types of nutrition here: parasitic mode of nutrition, insectivorous, saprophytic mode of nutrition and symbiosis. So we can move on to one by one in detail. Okay, what is parasitic mode of nutrition? So, a very common example is cascata. Okay, what this cascata is? A parasitic plant which do not have chlorophyll. Okay, see, just take it as an example of a plant. Okay, where the cascata is going to climb or tangle it in this plant. This plant is the host. Where this cascata is going to entangle us is the, that cascata is the parasite. Why it depends on the another plant? Because this cascata will not have chlorophyll, so it cannot produce their own food. Okay, so the plant which this parasite is going to depend on for its nutrition is the host plant. Cascata is the parasite. Are you all clear with this? So there will not be any beneficial. What this is going to suck all the nutrient from the host plant. Only this parasite is going to get benefited. Okay, so this this cascata will climb on the host plant to derive its nutrients. We have another examples also, crops, Rafflesia, all these are the example of parasitic plants, parasitic mode of nutrition. So parasitic mode of nutrition is nothing but where the plant is going to depend on the host plant to derive its nutrition. Next we'll move on to the insectivorous plant. Not only we humans are non-vegetarians, even we have some plants which also are non-vegetarians. Okay, what happened? What is this? What is that? We have insectivorous plants which trap small insects for their food. Why, ma'am? Why do they need this insects? Okay, first we'll just see the structure of the or the modification of insectivorous plant. Example, a very common example of insectivorous plants are Venus trap fly and pitcher plant. What this will do? See, this Venus trap fly will modify the leaf as a bell jar. Okay, so these plants are normally very colorful and attractive. What happens? This insects will come to the, when it is very colorful and attractive, the insects will reach this bell jar. Okay, suddenly what happened? This plant will capture the insect and trap it. But why do they need this? See, as we have already discussed, plants need nitrogen also. What happened? This plant will normally will be present in the acidic soil where the lissom or where the rhizobium bacteria cannot be present. Okay, that time what happens? This plant will take the nitrogenous source from the insects. Okay, it traps it and with the help of its digestive juices, it digests the insects and the and get nitrogenous substances. Okay, and in order to fulfill the nitrogen content, this plants will take the insects. Okay, now have you understood? So insectivorous plants will trap small insects. They are very attractive and colorful. With it kills and help with the help of digestive juices, it kills the insects. Why they need this? They be to in order to fulfill their nitrogen requirement. The very common examples are Venus trap fly and pitcher plant. Okay, the leaves are modified as a bell jar. This is all about the insectivorous mode of nutrition. Next, you can able to see bread. Okay, bread, where if you left it for 2 or 3 days in an open space, what you can able to see? You can able to see green color or a white color or a brown or color, some hairy like substances all over the bread. Okay, many of us will have to love to eat mushrooms also. Nowadays we get many kind of dishes prepared with mushrooms. Okay, mushroom, and we can able to see some back, we cannot able to see bacteria through our naked eyes, but when it is, then you see some dead and decayed or some spoiled food, there is a growth of bacteria in it. Okay, what are all the very common thing about bacteria, mushroom, bread mold? What is the common thing here? Well, the common is the nutrition, the mode of nutrition they share. The mode of nutrition, which type of nutrition they share is the saprophytic mode of nutrition or saprotrophs. These organisms like bacteria, molds, fungi, mushroom, all these organisms shares a type of nutrition called as saprotrophs. What is that? Saprotrophs are nothing but organisms which derive their nutrients from the dead and decaying matter. Clear all of you? So the organisms which depend upon the dead and decaying matter for their nutrition is said to be saprophytic mode of nutrition or saprotrophs. What they'll do? They'll produce some digestive juices. Because of that, they will derive the nutrients from the dead and decaying matter. Clear? Next comes the symbiosis. The definition may be quite difficult to understand, that there'll be mutual, the symbiosis is nothing but the organism get mutually benefited. okay, but it is quite very easy to understand also. Mutually benefited, they have a very good relationship, a friendship bond between two organisms, okay. We have already discussed about the rhizobium bacteria which helps the atmospheric nitrogen for the plants to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. Normally this will be seen in the leguminous plants, like all the pulses, dolls, we can able to see this rhizobium bacteria. What happens, rhizobium will helps the plant by fixing the nitrogen. In order to that, plant will give shelter, other nutrients to the rhizobium bacteria. So both are mutually benefited, okay. So the mutual relationship between two organisms, where they two are mutually benefited, are said to be symbiosis. We have another example also, algae and fungi. What happens, algae, we all know that they'll undergo photosynthesis, where they can produce their own food. Yes, so here algae produces own food and fungi uses the shelter. A very common example which is given in your book is lichens, okay, or you can use to pronounce lichens also. So they also share the symbiotic relationship, that is symbiosis. Mutually both are benefited. So we have four types of heterotrophic or special type of nutrition, okay. Parasitic, insectivorous, saprotrophs, symbiosis. So parasitic nutrition is where the parasite depend on the host to derive the nutrition. Insectivorous, where the plant depend on the insects for its nutrition. And saprotrophs, which derive nutrients from the dead and decaying matter. Symbiosis, where two organisms are mutually benefited in order to take the food, okay, in order to derive the nutrition. I hope you are all clear with the four types of nutrition, that is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Next comes, how does nutrients replenish the soil? See, when during that, if you see the farmers, how they do cropping, okay, there will be crop rotation, right? Why? Because when we all know that roots will absorb the nutrients and minerals from the soil, water and nutrients from the soil. In order to get a very good amount of crops, we need a good amount of very fertilized soil, right? How the soil can be replenished by the nutrients? Normally we used to go with fertilizers, manures. Manures are natural thing. Fertilizers, we used to give nitrogen, phosphorus, like that we used to give, right? How these nutrients are replenished by the fertilizers, manures. So here also this rhizobium, which helps to convert the atmospheric nitrogen into the simpler form, will helps in the replenishment of nutrients. Have you all clear this? So once the soil getting utilized by the plants, the replenishment will take place, okay, by maybe cultivating leguminous plants, their crop rotation you'll be studying in your next class. So replenishment happens with the help of this rhizobium bacteria and also with the help of some manures, okay. I hope you all understood about the nutrition in plants. Coming here, how do we get nutrient, what kind of nutrition mode we do, okay. That is, the mode of nutrition what the human follow is holozoic nutrition. Normally plants will take very simple food, that is carbohydrate, but we humans used to take complex number of food, I mean complex substances like protein, vitamin, minerals, everything, okay. So in this mode of nutrition, holozoic mode of nutrition, organism takes in complex food and break down into simple food, okay. Now all of you relax and take a deep breath, because this nutrition, holozoic mode of nutrition, will be discussing in the next session in your chapter 2, nutrition in animals. If there is any doubt or clarification regarding nutrition in plants, you can kindly text me, and hope you all understood this session about nutrition in plants. Thank you.